Welcome to Hapai Gaiwa Podcast. サコと大地と
木村晴樹の
マイケルは英語でバイリンガル会話形式でひいきにしているものを楽しく語らうポッドキャストです。
ひいきりいき June Sensei。皆さんこんにちは。キミシェンヌのロレッタです。One of the biggest questions I get from you guys is how did I learn to speak Japanese? How to speak naturally? How to learn to speak without thinking about it? What really took me from a textbook robot to a person who can actually speak was listening to and mimicking podcasts almost every day. As someone who's really bad at memorizing, shadowing and mimicking let me build muscle memory so that I don't have to remember. I don't have to memorize everything because it's actually just something I got used to doing over and over again. I had about two or three podcasts that I alwayshad on rotation, but now, today, about 10 years later, they don't really exist anymore. So starting a month ago, I went back to the drawing board and started downloading and going through different podcasts and figuring out which ones I thought would be really good for you guys. So today I'm going to show you my all new updated list of my top three favorite podcasts that I use to learn and improve my Japanese, and a few extras as well.
なんか本当にさっきのセリフをパクってる感じなんだけど、今回は私がまさにひいきにしているポッドキャストを紹介するトピックです。
So I separated my picks into two different categories. Ones were really more academic formal learning. These were focused on structured lessons, grammar, etc. Something that you would listen to kind of like in addition to or in place of a textbook.And then the other kind, which is more conversational, radio style, spoken style of Japanese. I have top picks for both categories, but for today's video, I want to specifically look at the more radio style, conversation-based podcasts.Because I think these are the ones that are really going to help you get talking more quickly. So the first one actually came straight from you guys, and that is Hiiki Biiki. This one was by far the most popular podcast that you guys mentioned that you were already using. And I was pleasantly surprised. The hosts Daiichi and Haruka, one guy and a girl, basically sit down and have a fun conversation about what they've been enjoying recently. What I liked about this podcast is that it was very natural, the sound quality was very good, there's just a little bit of music in the background to keep your interest, but it's not too distracting so that you can really just kind of focus on what they're saying. So you really feel like you're just kind of like a fly on the wall sitting enjoying the conversation, and it's kind of like a chance to hear real natural Japanese between two native speakers. It's easy to pick up the topics because they tell you before they start what they're going to talk about. You can also see the topics kind of listed up on their website. That being said, this podcast is all in Japanese, and I looked all over and as far as I could tell, it doesn't seem like there are any official scripts that you can use to study the Japanese or to see exactly what they're saying.The biggest downside I would say about this podcast is that it is no longer officially airing anymore. It is off the air. But if you go to their website, you can find every single episode, click and listen to the one that you like, and you can hear what they've already made. The Japanese that they use and the topics that they cover are pretty general, not too time specific, so you can still enjoy them.And, you know, just download the ones you like and enjoy and go from there. This podcast does not seem to originally be for language learning. However, the audio is clean and well produced. So I would recommend this podcast for anyone who is N3, anyone who's a comfortable advanced intermediate. I would especially recommend this for someone who's just looking for something to play in the background, cushion your Japanese studies with more natural speech. I think this is a great way to start. You can do that by looking at the topic list that they have under every episode, picking out words or topics that you know they're going to talk about.Look those up and then start listening. So this next podcast is one of my all-time favorites. I used to have this really mind-numbing job digitizing old library catalogs in the basement of my college library, hours on end with nobody in sight. It was just me and these books and my mind going crazy. And the only thing that really kept me from losing my mind down in these library catacombs waspodcast. I used to listen to podcasts for 4, 5, 6 hours a day. Way back in the day, the only podcast that was really bilingual Japanese English was this one, SBS Japanese Podcast. It was really kind of like the first of its kind.And I would listen to this one on repeat. Rather than listen to all of them, I would only pick out the ones that specifically seemed really interesting to me or easier to listen to for me. The host would come on, he'd introduce the topic, give a little bit of background, and usually bring on a guest speaker. So there was someone different for every topic every time. And they usually would always have very clean,very clear, very easy to listen to Japanese. I loved hearing about the annual National Japanese Speech Contest, where Australian citizens who learned to be really good at Japanese would be interviewed in Japanese and talk about their speech and their Japanese studies. It was really good to hear other learners of Japanese speak Japanese. There was the Master of Wine episode talking about food and food pairings and like all this good yummy stuff. Rock bands, there was festivals, sports, comedy. This is what I did. I listened to 3 or 4 of these episodes on repeat. for hours for like almost a year, I would say. The SBS podcast is still available today. The host has changed, it seems like, since I used to listen to it, but it's still just as clear, still just as clean, still just as good content. And I really think this is a good way to start picking out relevant topics that are talked about in a relatable way. It's not necessarily a formal learning tool, but just like Hikibiki, I think this would be great for commutes. I think this would be great in the shower. This is one of those great ones to just keep listening to on repeat and start actually mimicking your favorite speakers or your favorite episodes. In addition, you can use your phone, you can use free programs like Audacity, and you can actually record yourself imitating the actual clips that you're listening to. This is something I used to do. I would listen to the original and then make a playlist where my mimicked version was put right under it so it would play next, and I would listen to that on loop, and you really start to internalize where you messed up, why it sounded weird, the gap between the native version and yours. So that's something that I did for hours, it really helped. The third podcast is Happa Eikaiwa Podcast. I should just say it normal. Happa Eikaiwa Podcast. When I found it, I was like, this is what I've been looking for. Happa Eikaiwa Podcast is hosted by Jun Senesai. He speaks Japanese and American English, both fluently, perfectly bilingual. The thing that I love about this podcast is that it covers news, it covers relevant topics, but the structure of it makes it so easy to learn from, especially if you're trying to learn from English to Japanese. It starts out first with a brief kind of like introductory, relevant news bit. Recently, he talked a lot about the Super Bowl, American football, hipsters, barbecue, Austin, Portland, all this stuff. It's so American. It was like, am I home? He talks about that in Japanese, and then he re-says what he says in English. You get to hear this really relevant, authentic versions of what you already know and live every day, but now also in Japanese. There are questions, so there's kind of like a little activity. Then after the questions, there's another section where there's a guest speaker, and on top of that, there's also transcripts! Finally, transcripts! Why does nobody make transcripts to their podcast? The podcast itself is free, but if there's an episode you really like, you can purchase these specific transcripts for one episode or for all of them or whatever you want. Whatever he's talking about, he first says it in English so that the Japanese listeners have to really strain and focus hard, and then he repeats it in Japanese to sort of reinforce the learning. But as a native English speaker, on the reverse side, it gives you English context of what he's about to say, even if you're not necessarily at that level. You can kind of bootstrap your way in because the English comes first. So with this one, you can start maybe high beginner, intermediate. You can start picking up words, phrases, and if you really want to dig deep into it, you can use those transcripts for your favorite episode, and you can really just start to break down the Japanese that he's using and figure out how to incorporate that into your own speech. The downside of this podcast is that when I first listened to it, it seemed very cheesy, but after a while I kind of realized that that was his charm. That's what kept it interesting. Yes, it has great content, it has an easy to use format, and it has transcripts, which makes it perfect for studying, but it's also interesting. Even though it's cheesy, that's kind of what makes it good, and I found myself coming back to this one more than anything. It may take a little getting used to, but give it a couple listens, but it's still writing now, the sound quality is great, it comes with transcripts. Honestly, I think anyone, if you are N4, maybe even N5, but I would say if you're N4, 3, 2, right there in the middle, if you're looking for not only something to listen to, but also something to actually study from, I would really recommend this one. So those are my top three, but that's not all. I do have a few bonus podcasts. Honorable mentions goes to Bilingual News, which is hosted by Michael and Mami. After Hikibiki, Bilingual News is the podcast that most of you guys mentioned I should check out. In a nutshell, this one is exactly what the title sounds like. This is news done bilingually. Every week they introduce a new relevant news topic, business news, social news. One of their most recent episodes was about the new batch of emojis that just came out. They introduce it both in Japanese and in English, and then after the topic is introduced, they start just talking about it. Both hosts, Michael and Mami, are bilingual, but Mami tends to respond in Japanese and Michael tends to respond in English, although they both mix in a little bit here and there. One of the good things about this podcast is that they also have transcripts available. Thank you! They have a special official Mojiokoshi Apuri transcription app that they actually produce themselves. It gives you the scripts of what they're talking about in text format. You can highlight and copy and paste it into your favorite dictionary. The podcast itself is free, but the transcripts you have to pay for a subscription. Honestly, I think that the transcript is the most valuable part of this, but it's up to you if you want to just use it for listening or if you actually want to go deeper and use it to study. So this podcast, I wouldn't recommend it for everyone specifically because the content is a bit more editorial style. Sometimes it's more opinionated than content based. This one is a little bit more tension hikui. Excitement level is brought down. So you may like that if you like more like calm, natural, kind of like laid back sort of talk. But for me, it was kind of hard to keep coming back to because if you are specifically trying to use this podcast for learning, you may find that the content can be distracting at times. Sometimes the topics themselves or the way that they talk about it can be a little bit crass. I think it's really good that they have both of them because it kind of keeps the tension levels and the conversation balanced. You know, that's one of the good things is that you have both of them, they're balanced, the way that they talk, they kind of even each other out. So if you're looking for more raw conversation, more opinionated conversation, the other thing to be aware of is because it's bilingual, the streams of sound, the streams of content that they use are usually interrupted. So mommy may start speaking in Japanese, but Michael will respond in English. I read in an article, he said it was really important to have a podcast that gives an English context because if it's all Japanese, you don't know where to start and it's overwhelming, it's too much. I definitely get where he's coming from, but I also wish they had a section which was all Japanese or all English in addition to their conversation. I'd recommend this more for advanced speakers of Japanese, for N2, N1, specifically because it's bilingual and because the streams of sound are cut between English and Japanese. I would use this to pick up phrases, to learn how to turn a phrase, to learn how to respond to someone. If you are a guy, this is one of the few podcasts that features an adult male who talks about adult male topics that may interest you. If you are actually trying to practice formally learning Japanese, I would say obviously you need the transcripts. If you're trying to learn to speak casually at your office or to anyone who's like even slightly above you for more than two sentences, I don't think this is the type of content you would like. I think what you'll get out of this mostly is phrases, vocabulary, and ways to talk about really current relevant topics in short spurts. So that's where we're gonna leave it for now. These podcasts are definitely more for intermediate to advanced to higher advanced level speakers, specifically for people who are learning how to improve their speaking ability and not necessarily textbook learning. They're not going to replace formal studies. They're not going to help you pass N2 or N1 because you still have to do all the rest of the work. But they're really going to help you supplement your studies because they'll be interesting, relevant. They're going to help you speak Japanese better because they'll make you excited to speak it. Relevant topics, real words, real phrases that you can talk about in English and now also in Japanese. Talking about your comfort zone and relationships and where can you get the best barbecue in Texas and your favorite team, are they going to win? Relevant, actual, real talk, and I really appreciate that. From our passive, topic-based conversation, I would definitely say Hikibiki and Bilingual News are great for that. For a little bit more structure, something that's easier to listen to, and something that you can really study from, I would definitely recommend SBS Podcast, and in addition to that, Hapa Ikaiwa Podcast. I can't get enough of that one. I really love that one. Like, Jun Senesak, he really outdid himself. Obviously, there's so many more podcasts. You know, the NHK Radio News, if you look at their website, there's beginner-level podcasts, travel-based, actual lessons inside of podcasts. There's the Japanese Pod. This will be more useful for intermediate and beginner speakers of Japanese. I'm going to look at those in my next podcast review, but for today, I just wanted to get us talking. If you have time, try giving them all a listen. I'd be curious which ones were your favorite. 日本の皆さん、どうですか?バイリンガル形式のポッドキャストとか、ひいきにしてるポッドキャストありますか?おすすめありますか?こういうポッドキャストをロレッタにレビューしてほしいとか、この英語のポッドキャスト合ってるっていうのがあれば、ぜひ気楽にコメントで書いてください。それでは、今日もご視聴ありがとうございました。Thanks for listening, guys. This is Loretta coming to you from Kemish Channel. In addition to my YouTube, Instagram, and Twitter, maybe we should start a podcast. What do you guys think? Let me know in a comment below. And I promise I won't talk like this. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.